In this experiment, we will verify the Lambert-Beard's law. We have already discussed the theory of it. And now we will demonstrate the experiment to you. Now for this experiment, we require three solutions. One is the 0.1 millimolar Mohr salt solution. Mohr salt means, you know, it is the ammonium sulfate, ferrous sulfate, and water of crystallization is present. And from its molecular weight, we have exactly weighed the Mohr salt, and we have prepared 250 ml of 0.1 millimolar of that solution with distilled water. Now, there are two other solutions. One is hydroxyl ammonium chloride 0.5 molar. It is used to maintain pH. And this is the 110 phenanthrolene, which is the indicator molecule. At a certain pH, which will be maintained by this hydroxyl ammonium chloride, this 110 phenanthrolene will form a colored complex with the ferrous ion present in the Mohr salt. Now, using these three solutions, we will prepare, or rather we will dilute this 0.1 millimolar Mohr salt in these three volumetric fluxes, and we will put the same amount of these two solutions. Only Mohr salt solution will be, we will vary. That means we will vary the ferrous ion concentration. Obviously, if we vary the ferrous ion concentration, then the amount of color formed will be different. That means absorbance or optical density, that is OD, will be different. And we will measure that different OD for different ferrous ion concentrations. And we will plot that. If it is linear plot, that is OD versus concentration of ferrous ion, then we will say that Lambert-Beard's law is valid. Now obviously here there are some limitations. Lambert-Beard's law is valid, that is, gives a linear plot only for a certain range of optical density. That's a different question. Here, whatever concentration range we will take, under that concentration range, you should get a linear variation of optical density with ferrous ion concentration. So now we will show you that experiment. Now we are preparing the solution. In first one, we will take 1 ml of Mohr salt in first volumetric flux, second one 2 ml, then third one 3 ml, like that. This is the pipette man. In this pipette man, we can fix the volume. This is 1 100 means. It is better we put it in a this type of experiment, you should be very careful because there should not be any contamination. All the UVBs, that is spectrophotometric estimation or conductivity metric or pH metric, it is better whenever you use anything, any type of beaker or burette, whatever it may be, any apparatus, you should clean it very properly and rinse it with distilled water. Okay, this is 1 ml. Now,
accumulated.
No.
This is only 1 ml.
This is only 1 ml.
This is the 5 ml.
This is 2. Now we are giving 2 ml. Then we will give 3 ml. Okay. Then in each bottle we will give 2 ml of hydroxyammonium chloride. And then we will give 1 ml of phenanthrolene in each of this solution. And you can see color formation has started. Now we have to fill it up up to this mark, that is we have to complete this volume up to 100 ml. Moshan, jolla. Okay, you can see it is filled up to this mark. That means it is 100 ml. Now you have to wait for some time so that coloration is complete. That is complexation reaction. You should give some time or allow some time so that this complexation reaction becomes complete. Now this is solution 1, where concentration of ferrous ion was only 1 ml. And here you can see color is less, coloration is less. And gradually, with increasing concentration of ferrous ion, coloration gradually increases. So obviously optical density will increase, but we have to check whether that optical density and concentration varies linearly. Because your Lambert-Beard's law requires that optical density and concentration should vary linearly. If it varies linearly, then your Lambert-Beard's law will be validated. Now, at least you have to give 10 minutes of time so that coloration is complete. And in the meanwhile, I am showing you this instrument. This is a single, not dual beam, this is a single beam visible spectrophotometer. We cannot measure absorbance in UV range. We can measure here in the visible range only. And it is a single channel, not dual beam, single beam. From one side, because from this side actually, your visible light will come of different frequencies or different wavelengths. And here we will put our sample in a cuvette, and this is the detector part. So in this particular case, the absorbance maximum will be around 510 nanometer. Hence, we will measure the optical density or OD at 510 nanometer, you can see we have set it. We have set the wavelength for measurement at 510 nanometer. Now first, to negate any instrumental artifact, we will first give simple distilled water. Now distilled water ideally should not absorb in this 510 range. That means here your transmission should be 100%. I am giving that water in this compartment and we are measuring the transmission. Now we will make this transmission 100%. That is zero absorbance. So now you can see we have make the transmission at 100% level. Hence, ideally now at this 510 nanometer, your solvent will not absorb anything. Whatever absorption you will get, or I will show you the values, those values will come due to absorption of that complex. What complex? The complex between ferrous ion and 110 phenanthrolein. Okay. So now one by one I will take from lower concentration to higher concentration. I will take those in that same cuvette. And I will measure the absorbance, or note down the absorbance. And always you have to cleared the surface of the cuvette so that there is no contamination which can absorb any light. So this is the lowest concentration of ferrous. Okay, now we have to make mode in absorption mode. No, absorption machine. Oh, well, we have to give enter, right? With solvent water, we have already made the transmission 100% at 510 nanometer. That means at that 510 nanometer, solvent water don't involve in absorption. Now we will place one by one from lower concentration to higher concentration. We will place the solution and we will measure the absorption. Now as solvent is not taking, is involving in absorption, hence whatever optical density or absorption value you will see, that is due to the complex only, that is ferrous ferancholin complex. Now this is the lowest concentrated solution and let's see at 510 whatever absorption you will get. So this is the absorption mode and you can see with lowest concentration the value is 0.015. For absorption there is no unit, it is a unitless quantity. The absorption is 0.0, it is a relative value, it is 0.015. Now with solution 2, okay, I think we have given point. Okay, now this is solution. And every time, as I told you, we have to clear the surface, clean the surface. And you have to go from lower concentration to higher concentration gradually. Now you can see for solution 2 the absorption value is 0.027. Now solution 3. It is better slightly you rinse it and then you take the solution. This is 0.038. Now solution 4. It is 0.048. And the last one, which is most concentrated, you can see it is 0.059. Now one thing, your Mohr salt solution which we have prepared by weighing, it was concentration was 0.1 millimolar, and in this solution 1 we have taken 1 ml of it and we have diluted up to 100 ml. Hence using V1H1 is equal to V2H2 formula, you have to calculate what is the actual concentration of Mohr salt in this solution 1. Similarly, in solution 2, there is 2 ml of that stock solution of Mohr salt. In solution 5, there is 5 ml of this stock solution. In that way, for all these 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 solutions, you have to calculate what is the actual strength of ferrous ion in those solutions, and you have to write this absorption values, and then you have to plot concentration of actual concentration of ferrous ion in those solutions versus optical density or absorption, and you have to show it whether it is linear or not. If it is linear, then it will verify your Lambert-Beard's law. This is all.